More and more people are becoming overweight. Experts call it an obesity epidemic, and they're talking about normal people like Barry. Barry is, well, let's just say not very happy about his weight. He already has high blood pressure, and he's starting to worry because he's heard that obesity can cause other serious health problems like diabetes, heart disease, and even cancer. Barry wants to eat less salt and lose weight. Much easier said than done. It's not just a problem of self-discipline. To plan a healthy diet, Barry needs basic facts about the foods in his supermarket, like how much sugar, fat, and salt they contain. The British came up with a very good idea. Take a well-known and easy-to-understand symbol and use it on food packages to mark the levels of key nutrients. The amounts are always given per 100 grams, making it easy to compare products. The color coding gets the message across even to children. Red is for high levels, amber for medium levels, and green for low levels. For the first time, reliable nutritional facts can be presented on the front of packages in a plain and simple way. However, some retailers and food manufacturers were worried this label may hurt their sales. Why? Well, let's look at this box of cereal, Barry's favorite breakfast food. It happens to contain more than 35% sugar, and yet it's called Fitness Fruits. Giving it an eye-catching high sugar label would destroy advertising illusions. So Tesco, Nestle and Company came up with their own labeling system to pull the plug on traffic lights. The guideline daily amounts, a mixture of complicated numbers and percents. What happens when our friend Barry finds this GDA label on his fitness fruits? He reads that it contains 14.1 grams of sugar per serving, and this is only 16% of the recommended daily amount for, an average middle-aged woman. Then Barry discovers that the numbers are actually based on a serving size of 40 grams. That's certainly much less than he eats every morning. Checking out other cereal boxes, Barry finds many different portion sizes. So basically, he'd need a calculator to figure out whether other cereals are healthier than his fitness fruits. That's why consumers and health organizations are speaking out in favor of color-coded labeling. With traffic light labels, Barry can compare products at a glance and choose the healthiest. Now, the choice is up to the politicians. The proposed EU legislation would not only make GDA-type labeling mandatory, it would actually prohibit member states from requiring traffic light labels on a national level. We believe this must not be allowed to happen, for Barry and for all the other consumers out there. Traffic lights. Color your food. For information, an email campaign at www.foodwatch.eu/trafficlights.